Hi guys, marhaba. Welcome to my channel, the best place for you to learn the modern standard Arabic language as well as the Iraqi accent. In today's lesson, I'm going to explain to you everything you want to know about the Arabic vowels. For those of you who already watched my previous series of lessons about the Arabic alphabet, you might still remember, I hope you still remember, that the Arabic alphabet consists of 28 letters, 25 consonants, and 3 vowels. However, that's not all. In Arabic language, we have more 3 vowels that do not have place in the Arabic alphabet, but they are so essential, super important for the Arabic language, for the pronunciation, and for the script. And they are present in each and every word that we say, but they do not have a place in the alphabet. So in today's lesson, I'm going to explain to you again the 3 long vowels and the 3 extra vowels that we have and that are not included in the Arabic alphabet. So yalla, let's begin the lesson. I'm going to start with the 3 long vowels that are part of the Arabic alphabet. The first vowel, and it's the first letter of the Arabic alphabet, and it's called alif, and it's pronounced as a long a. And this is how it is written. As you can see, it's just a simple vertical stroke. All right? This vowel can come at the beginning of the word, it can come in the middle of the word, it can come at the end of the word. So I'm going to give you now examples of this sound a in all 3 options. So let's start with the first option when it comes at the beginning of the word. Now, I told you that this is the way how alif is written as a simple vertical stroke. However, when it comes at the beginning of the word, we must add a small wave on top of it so we know we have to pronounce it as a long a. Why? Because the alif have also other functions than just being pronounced as the letter A, and we will come to that later on in this lesson. But for now, let's concentrate on the long vowel A. So when we want to write the long vowel A, we have to add on top of this stroke a small wave, and then we know that we should pronounce this letter as A. So an example for that is the word amal, amal, which means hopes. Here you can see there is the first letter, it's the alif with this wave on top of it, which means amal, hopes. Another example is the name Adam, Adam, which is Adam. Yeah, it's a male name, Adam. We also have it in the Arabic language, and it's pronounced Adam, Adam. Great. Let's go to the next option when the alif or the long vowel A is in the middle of the word. For example, very simple word, bab, bab, which means door, bab. Here you can see the A or the long vowel A is written as simple stroke in the middle, it's alif. Here we don't need to put this wave because we know it's pronounced as A. All right? Let's go to the next option when the long A is at the end of the word. Now here, when we write, we have 2 options how to write the long A at the end. One option is that it will be written in a similar way as it is written in the middle, as a simple stroke, vertical stroke. And an example for that is the word hedaya, hedaya, which means gifts, yeah, plural, gifts. Or zawaya, zawaya, which means corners. Here you can see at the end of the word we have the simple vertical stroke, which is the long vowel A. Now this way of writing the A at the end of the word, it's called alif mad or alif mamduda. Okay, this is how we call it. It's a grammatical term, but you don't have to really remember it. It's just for me, I want to explain to you the difference. Now, the second option, how we can write the long vowel A at the end is this way. It looks like a small duck and we call it Alif Maqsura. Alif Maqsura. Okay, it's a grammatical term, you don't have to memorize it. But I want you to know it because when you see a word which is written and it has this small duck at the end, you will immediately know that this is a long vowel, A. An example for that is, for example, the word ala, ala, which means on top, on something, ala, yeah, ala. Another example can be the name Leila, Leila. It's a feminine name, beautiful name, Leila. Again, you can see here at the end of the word, there is this small duck or Alif Maqsura. And we again pronounce it as a long vowel, A. A, Leila. Now, let's go to the second long vowel of the Arabic alphabet, which is the vowel U, or we call it Wa. Wa. Now, this is how it's written. And this is the one of the two exceptions of the Arabic alphabet. Maybe you also still remember, I mentioned it in one of my previous lessons, that the Arabic language is very phonetic, yeah? Which means that it is pronounced exactly the same way as it is written. Unlike other languages, for example, English language or French language or German language or other languages. However, there are two exceptions and this is the first one of them. Why? This long vowel U can sometimes be pronounced as W, W, W. It's like English W, W. Unfortunately, we don't have a rule that will tell us in which word it's pronounced as long U and in which it is pronounced as W. So we have to memorize it, that's important. And this is the only way how we will know how to pronounce it properly. So let me give you now examples of both options. One option is when this long vowel is pronounced as U and some and another examples when it's pronounced as W. Okay, so let's start with the W. So we have, for example, the word Warda, 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 which means flower. You can hear it starts with the sound W and that's the long vowel U, in this case pronounced as W. Another example can be the word Walad, 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 which means boy. Again, here you can hear the word starts with the sound W, which is the long vowel U, in this case pronounced as W. The another option how to pronounce the long vowel U is U. For example, in the word boom, boom, which means all. Yeah, the bird, all. Boom, boom. Another option is the word ruh, ruh, with the guttural h at the end, ruh, not ruh, not ruh, it's ruh, and it means soul or spirit, ruh. All right, so this is the second option of how to pronounce the long vowel u. The third vowel is the third long vowel that has a place in the Arabic alphabet is the vowel E. And this is the second exception to the rule that I told you just a while ago, that all the letters are pronounced the same way. This is the second exception because also the long vowel E can sometimes be pronounced as Y. Y. All right? So again, let me give you some examples. For example, the word yed, yed, which means hand, palm, yeah, hand, yed. Here, we put, when we write, we put the long vowel E, but we pronounce it as yed, y, not E, y. Another example is yom, yom, which means day. Again, here, it's pronounced as y, all right? Now, another option is that it is pronounced as E. For example, the masculine name Ali, Ali, Ali. It's a very popular Arabic masculine name and it ends with the long vowel E. In this case, it is pronounced as E, Ali. Another option is, for example, the word Fil, Fil, which means elephant, feel. Again, here it's the long vowel E and it's pronounced as long vowel E, feel. Or another word is ريح, ريح. Again, the H at the end is the guttural H, not ريح, not ريح, it's ريح. And it means air, yeah, or wind, sorry. It means wind, ريح. These are the three long vowels that are present in the Arabic alphabet. Now let's go to the three short vowels that don't have a place in the Arabic alphabet, and we call them the diacritics. Let's start with the first one, which is the short vowel eh, eh. And this short vowel, sometimes it's pronounced as short a, a, but mostly as e, but sometimes in few words it can be pronounced as a. And in Arabic language we call it fatha, fatha. You don't have to remember that, but I want you to know that's the name of the short vowel e, it's fatha. Now this fatha can come in the beginning of the word, in the middle of the word, at the end of the word. It can be present more than once in one word, of course. And how we write this fatha? In general, all the three short vowels that are the short e, short I, and short u are written as small signs or symbols above or below the letter that comes before them. Again, I'm going to repeat that. It's very super important. We write them as a small signs or symbols above or below the letter that is before them. So the short vowel e, when it's at the beginning of the word, here we come to a small problem because there is no other letter that comes before, because it starts with e. I'll give you an example of such a word, very simple, very crucial word, ana. Ana, which means me, ana. As you can hear, it starts with the short vowel e. Now, when we want to write it, how do we write it? Because we don't have any other word, letter that comes before it. So we have to find a way. And here comes our elif. I told you just a while ago that elif has two functions, have many functions, and this is one of its functions. What is the function? The function is that here we can use it as a base on which we are going to place our fatha. Now, fatha is written above the letter that comes before it. So what we are going to do, we are going to take the elif, which is a simple stroke, a vertical stroke, as you can see. And normally you would say, okay, we have the base, now we can put our fatha, which is written as a small stroke, very small, small stroke, tiny stroke, and it's elevated. It's not horizontal. It's a little bit elevated like this or like this. And we will say, okay, we have the elif, we have the base, now we can put our fatha on top of it, our short e. It's not so easy, unfortunately, because in Arabic language, we have to put another symbol or another letter on top of the elif, and only then we can put our short e on top of it. Now, what is that small symbol? It's a very unique Arabic letter, which is called hamza. Hamza. This letter looks like this, like a small two, number two. Again, it doesn't have a place in the Arabic alphabet, but it's super important to Arabic language. Really, believe me. There is no place for me in this lesson to explain to you everything about hamza, but I am preparing a special lesson dedicated to hamza. But here I'm going to only tell you that we are going to use this hamza, this symbol, on top of our elif, just as a to create a base on which we will put our small hamza, small fatha. So how we will write the e at the beginning of the word? We will put the elif, then we will put the hamza on top of it, this small two, and then we will put Above this hamza, the short angled stroke that represents the short vowel e. And this is how we create the sound e at the beginning of the word. So, ana looks like this. Of course, there are many, many, many words that start with the short vowel e. I'm not going to go through them because there are many of them, but ana is a very good example of that. Now, if ana comes in the middle of the word, for example, in the word ketebe, ketebe. Here, ketebe means he wrote. Yeah, it's a verb, past verb for a female, for a male, ketebe, he wrote. And here you can hear there are three short vowels, e. Ke, te, be. So this is also a very good example to give you. In this word you can see how we use and how we write the short vowel e at the beginning of the word, but it doesn't start, this word doesn't start with the sound e, it starts with k, yeah? So we have the letter k, it means that we can write above k the short vowel e, the small stroke above k. And this is the way how we create k. Then we add the t. And again, because it's ke, te, so we have to write the short vowel e above the t. So it will be kete. And then we have the b, and it's the last letter of the word, but it's not the last sound of the word, because we say ketebe. So again, above b, we have to put the short stroke, which is the fetha, or the short sound of e. And in this word, you can see we have three short vowels e. Ke, te, be. Great! So this is all about fatha, or the short vowel e. Let's go to the next short vowel, which is u. In Arabic, it's called dhamma. Dhamma. Again, it's a grammatical term. You don't have to really memorize it, but it's good for you to know. Dhamma is the short vowel u. Short vowel u, exactly the same way as the short vowel e, is written above the letter that precedes them. All right? In this case, again, it can come at the beginning of the word, it can come in the middle of the word, it can come at the end of the word. Yeah, there are all these options. When it begins, when the word begins with the short vowel u, is the same story as the short vowel e. Again, because we have to have some letter that comes before, so we can put it on top of that letter. But here we don't have any letter because it starts with u. So we are again going to use our beautiful, very important letter alif, the vertical stroke. Again, we are going to put above it the hamza, the small number two. And we will put our dhamma, which looks like this. It's a small, of course, very small, tiny symbol above the hamza. And we create the sound of u at the beginning of the word. All right? And let me give you an example about that. Is the word which means mother. You can hear this word starts with the short vowel u at the beginning. So this is the way how it is written. Alif, on top of it there is the hamza, and the small dhamma, the small short vowel u, on top of it. Okay, another example for that can be, let's say, when it's somewhere in a different position, this dhamma. For example, in the word su'ile, 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 which means he was asked. It's a verb, past tense, masculine gender, su'ila, he was asked. So you can hear we have su'ila, su'ila. So we have dhamma, or the short vowel u, as a second sound of the word. So what we are going to do, we are going to write the letter s, and we will write the short vowel u above it. Yeah, as a small symbol, su'ila. Great! Let's go to the last short vowel, which is the e. E. The short vowel e, or we call it kasra in Arabic, kasra, is written as, again, in the similar way as the short vowel e, fatha, as a small leveled stroke, but in this case, not above the letter, but below the letter that comes before the short vowel e. All right? So, again, this short vowel e can come at the beginning of the word, can come in the middle of the word, it can come at the end of the word. In case it comes at the beginning of the word, we will use the same technique as we used for fatha and dhamma. We are going to take our beautiful letter alif, we will put it at the beginning. We will put our hamza on top of it, below it. And we will put the kasra, or the short stroke, below the hamza. So, we will create the sound e at the beginning of the word, the same way we created the sound of u and e at the beginning of the word. So, for example, we have the word ibn, which means son. Ibn starts with a short vowel e. You can hear that. And this is the way how it is written. We have the alif, we have the hamza below it, and then we have the small stroke below the hamza, which represents the short vowel e. Ibn, son. Another example is the word bint, which means girl or daughter. Bint. Here, the sound e, or the short vowel e, comes as the second sound after the consonant b, which makes the life more easier, because we have this the letter b, and we are going to write our kasra below b, which will represent the short vowel e. So when we see b with this small stroke below it, we know it's pronounced b, bint. And that's all, guys. So I hope you really now understand the concept of the Arabic vowels. I know it's a little bit a tricky subject, because some of those, exactly three of those short vowels, are not present in the Arabic alphabet. And another tricky part of this subject is that we Arabs, actually, we don't really write, when we write our scripts, we don't write all these short vowels. We don't write them. Although we know they are there, we pronounce them, but we don't write them. Let me give you a small example of that. Now you can see this picture. This is a screenshot of one Arabic website. It's a very famous lifestyle magazine called Zahrat al-Khalij. This is one of their articles published on their website. As you can see, there are hardly any short vowels here. There are no short e, there is no short vowel e, short vowel u, short vowel e, no kasra, no dhamma, no fatha. What does it mean? Does that mean that all these words don't have those sounds? No, they do have, but we don't write them. And this is the tricky part, especially for you guys who are just learning the Arabic language. For us Arabs, it's easy because we know how to pronounce these words properly with their short vowels, even if they are not written. For you guys, my advice would be, when you are in the learning process, when you learn the Arabic language, you have to write, when you write, you have to write all these short vowels. The kasra, the dhamma, the fatha, you have to write them, at least at the beginning, so you will really get used to them. And later on, when you know how to pronounce these words properly, okay, then you can just ignore them. And it will be much easier for you even to read any kind of Arabic text, because honestly, not only the websites, it's even the books, the magazines, the newspapers, they don't really write all these short vowels. Maybe some of them, but not all of them. And just let me give you one example. You have the word leki. It's present in this article. Let me show it to you again. You can see it now. Leki, You can hear there is the sound e and there is the sound e, the short vowel e, le, ki. But here in this word, you have no kasra, you have no fatha. We Arabs know it's leki. But maybe for you guys who are just learning the language, you might be confused. You don't know how to pronounce this word. Maybe you think it's luku or liki or leke. By the way, it can be leke because leki means for you female and leke means for you male. But we understand from the context of this article that it's meant to, and it's we are talking about the female, not about male, so we say leki. And normally it should be written this way, with the fatha above l and with the kasra below k, but we don't write it. So I know it's a little bit a tricky issue, but this is the way it is. This is the Arabic language. It's not easy sometimes, but I'm sure with practice you will learn it, and then you can really just ignore the small signs. You don't have to write them and you will be able to read fluently. All right, guys, so that's it for my lesson today, all about Arabic vowels. I hope I've explained it to you well. In case you have any questions or you want me to clarify other things about the vowels, please put your questions in the comments. I will be glad to answer you. And once you are here, and if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification bell so you will not miss any of my upcoming lessons, which, by the way, the next lesson is going to be about this unique Arabic sign or letter, which is called Hamza. And I hope you like this lesson, and thanks a lot. I see you in the next lesson. Bye, ma'a salama.